Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this panel. I have the pleasure and honor to present to you the Prime Minister of the Republic of Montenegro, Mr. Zdravko Krivokapić. Prime Minister Krivokapić will talk about the process of Montenegro's accession to the EU. Mr. Prime Minister, welcome to Athens and to the 6th Delphi Economic Forum. The floor is yours.
Hvala.
Dame i gospodo, dobrodošli na ovaj panel. Imam čast i zadovoljstvo da vam predstavim predsjednika vlade Crne Gore, gospodina Zdravka Krivokapića. Premijer Krivokapić će nam govoriti o procesu pridruživanja Crne Gore Evropskoj uniji. Još jednom želim mu dobrodošlicu, dobrodošli u Atinu i na 6. Delfski ekonomski forum.
Pa ja se vama zahvaljujem na pozivu i čini mi posebnu čast i zadovoljstvo, te se upravo nalazim u Atini, mjesto dakle je krenula demokratija koja će, ja se nadam, vrlo brzo zapljesnuti u izvornom smislu Crnu Goru.
Thank you very much for your invitation. Indeed, it is an honor and pleasure to be here in Athens, which is the cradle of democracy, which will hopefully very soon have a spillover effect in Montenegro.
Naravno, ako bi se osvrnuo na stanje koje je trenutno u Crnoj Gori, onda bih mogao se uporediti sa Grčkom prije 20 godina u oči olimpijade.
If I would have to make a comparison to the situation in Montenegro, I could draw a parallel and say that the state of affairs in Montenegro resembles that of the situation in Greece some 20 years ago at the time of the Olympics.
Jer imamo jedan problem koji je vezan za autoput, drugi koji je vezan za veliki dug koji je naslijedila ova vlada, i naravno treće, što je možda najznačajnije, veliko socijalno raslojavanje.
Actually, there are several problems or several issues that we are facing. The first problem is the highway loan that we have taken. Secondly, there is this major debt that this government has inherited from the previous one. And thirdly, there are major social discrepancies in our society.
I uz to sve imamo ovaj jedan veliki izazov sa kojim se sreće čitav svijet, a to je pandemija.
And on top of all of that, there is this major challenge that is globally present. This is the challenge of pandemic.
I pošto je Crna Gora pretežno turistička destinacija, i to avio destinacija, i to podsjeća na Grčku, pri čemu mi smo prošle godine imali vrlo skroman prihod od turizma koji iznosio negdje oko 159 miliona eura.
So actually, since Montenegro is a destination that is an airline accessible destination, it kind of resembles Greece, just that there is this difference, bearing in mind that last year we generated merely 159 million euros from our tourism industry.
Što je manje od 15% u odnosu na najbolju godinu, to je 2019.
Which is less than 15% in comparison to the best year, which is the year of 2019.
I mi činimo napore i u našem budžetu smo projektovali da će ova turistička sezona biti negdje na nivou 65% u smislu prihoda u odnosu na 2019. godinu.
So we are making these efforts, and within our budget we made a forecast that during this tourism season we will reach the level of 65% of this best season 2019.
I taj optimizam baziramo na dvije ključne činjenice. Jedna da je broj zaraženih u Crnoj Gori iz dana u dan manji, a druga na velikom broju imunizacije koja se radi u okviru našeg zdravstvenog sistema.
So we are basing our optimism on two facts. The first fact is that the number of people who are infected by the virus is dropping on a daily basis. And also we are paying a lot of attention and investing efforts into immunization, namely vaccination of our population.
Tako da računamo da će upravo zbog dobro organizovanog zdravstvenog sistema i te imunizacije kao i ovoga što je prošlo kroz narod, biti negdje više od 65% onih koji su prošli zarazu od COVID.
We are hopeful, therefore, that due to the good organization of our healthcare system, firstly, secondly, due to high level of vaccination, and thirdly, due to the fact that a lot of people had already contracted virus, have been through the virus, we will have around 65% of our population who will be resilient.
I zato posebno očekujem razumijevanje Grčke, jer ove sličnosti su tolike, ali iako se radi o dva različita sistema, jedan koji je veliki I jedan koji je mali.
That is why I expect, in a way, that Greece shows understanding for our situation, because there are so many similarities. Nevertheless, our two systems are different in terms of size, a big system and a small one.
Jer mali sistem jeste fleksibilniji, ali I osjetljiviji na svaki poremećaj.
Because small systems indeed are more flexible, but are also more vulnerable to all distortions.
Zato je naše opredeljenje istinsko, a to je put ka Evropskoj uniji koji nema alternative.
Therefore, our commitment is genuine. This is the path towards the EU, and there is no alternative to it.
Ako je prethodna vlast to radila u periodu od skoro 9 godina I bukvalno otvorila sva poglavlja, zatvorila samo 3, onda smo mi spremni da posvećeno, odgovorno I na najbolji mogući način ispunimo sve obaveze, posebno u dijelu vladavine prava koja nam nije na zavidnom nivou.
Therefore, bearing in mind the fact that the previous government has managed to open all the negotiating chapters, has been working on this for 9 years, but has managed to close only 3 negotiating chapters, we will pursue this path in the best way possible. We will address particularly the area of the rule of law, which is currently not at an enviable level in our country.
I zasigurno smo mi lideri na Zapadnom Balkanu u tom dijelu I ostaćemo na tom mjestu I biti prva sljedeća članica Evropske unije.
We are considered to be the leaders in the Western Balkans. We will certainly seek to remain in that position and be the first next EU member state.
Thank you very much for those very interesting things. I have 2 questions for you, Mr. Prime Minister. The first has to do with the European accession.
Hvala vam puno na ovim observacijama I interesantnom izlaganju. Imao bih za vas 2 pitanja. Prvo se odnosi na pristupanje Evropskoj uniji.
You said before that there is no alternative.
Već ste rekli da nema alternative tom putu.
So, what are the strongest challenges that Montenegro faces and faced during the negotiation process? This is my first question. And my second question is, I will insist a little more on the pandemic. And I would like to ask you what is the impact of the coronavirus pandemic on the economy of Montenegro, with special reference to the tourism industry, which is very important for you. And just to remind you, excuse me, we have 4 minutes. To not run out of time.
Kratko upozorenje, imamo još 4 minuta da nam ne istekne
vrijeme. Thank you very much.
Prvo pitanje tiče se...
Vi mu upozoravate što znate da ja ne mogu bez 45 minuta.
You're warning me because you know...
Ali ovoga puta ću morati u 5 minuta.
I have to speak for 45 minutes, but this time I will have to shorten it to 5 minutes.
What do I do, Mr. Prime Minister? We have to...
Pa vidite, u ovom prvom dijelu naš najvažniji zadatak zbog prihvatanja nove metodologije, ne želeći da budemo povlašćeni po bilo kom kriterijumu, Mi smo prihvatili novu metodologiju da bi na taj način serioznije prišli glavnom izazovu, a to je vladavina prava. To jest poglavlje 23 I 24.
Therefore, we accepted this new methodology. We don't want that anybody cuts us any slacks on that path. That is why we embarked on this methodology in order to seriously tackle all the challenges that are stemming from chapters 23 and 24.
Ja sam u razgovorima sa predstavnicima Evropske komisije želio da imam jasne ciljeve kako bih mogao da pratim njihovo ostvarenje.
I wanted in my talks with the representatives of the European Commission that they present me with some clear goals and aims so that I could target them clearly.
Pošto je to fluidno, a ja razmišljam inženjerski, onda sam zamolio da mi se napravi jedna tablica 83 privremena mjerila sa stanjem u ovom trenutku, ocjenom kako to poboljšati I kojim sredstvima I za koje vrijeme.
Therefore, since all of these criteria, aims and goals are so fluid, and since I'm of the engineering mindset, I requested that a table be made. And this table contains 83 interim benchmarks. And these benchmarks are all having their definitions. They have certain grades, assessments, how to achieve and to improve these benchmarks, and also what funds are required to do so.
Recimo, u okviru ekonomskog razvoja mi bi u ovom trenutku po prethodnoj metodologiji zatvorili 5 poglavlja.
If we would be working on the basis of the previous methodology at this moment, we would have been able to close 5 economic chapters.
Ali upravo kritično kod nas je vladavina prava i borba protiv organizovanog kriminala i korupcije.
Whilst precisely the rule of law and fight against organized crime and corruption are of key importance in our country.
Ova vlada će sve učiniti, ali ne može bez pravosuđa i skupštine da se na pravi način izbori sa tim izazovima.
This government will do everything it can, however, without the judiciary system and without the parliament, it cannot tackle these challenges the right way.
I pošto nema mnogo vremena, prelazim na drugo pitanje koje se tiče turizma. Ja mogu samo da kažem da je to još jedan poziv da će ova turistička sezona biti sigurno iznad naših očekivanja i da dođete u Crnu Goru potrebno je samo dobra volja.
Actually, since we're running out of time, I will now move on to tourism. What I wish to tell you is that this tourism season will certainly surpass all of our expectations. I would like that you show willingness and join us in Montenegro.
Jesmo sve uradili da naši gosti budu dočekani na najbolji način i da budu bezbjedni. Napravili smo odgovarajuće pravilnike, definisali protokole po svim hotelima i privatnim smještajima, obezbijedili da 10% hotelskih kapaciteta budu COVID apartmani, da svaki turista koji dođe u Crnu Goru, a bude zaražen, ima besplatno liječenje. Znači, mi smo činili sve što je do nas, ostaje samo do dragih turista da dođu na najljepšu destinaciju koja se može porediti sigurno i sa Grčkom, a to je Crna Gora.
Now we've done everything we could. We've made sure that our guests be safe and in the best of condition. Actually, we've provided for the rule books and protocols for the hotels and private accommodation, meaning that 10% of our hotel capacities will be designated as COVID apartments. So all the tourists who come to Montenegro who contract virus can be treated freely, free of charge. So we've done everything we can. Now it remains only that the tourists come to Montenegro and they are wholeheartedly invited to do so.
So, Mr. Prime Minister, thank you so much for this interesting presentation and thank you for respecting the time as well. I wish you the best for your tasks. And ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here with us. Thank you.
Hvala vam se najljepše.